staple for vegan cooks all over the country. And now, How It All Vegan is celebrating 10 years of culinary excellence. So joining us this morning with some vegan tips and a delicious recipe is co-author Sarah Kramer, back in the AM studios. Great to have you here.
Thanks. I'm glad to be back. I know. It's been 10 years I was here promoting How It All Vegan when it first came out.
Well, you know, we had to go back to the library.
Oh, no.
Oh, yeah. I think we've got it. Do we have, I think we got some... Oh, maybe we don't. Well, no, okay. Well,
we were wearing Hawaiian outfits. It wasn't good.
Okay.
It wasn't good.
Okay. Things have come a long way. I mean, just take a look at the book when you started. I mean,
well, this is the original book. Yeah. Tanya and I wrote it. We did it on a crude publishing program on my computer, and we printed it and bound it ourselves and sold it to friends for $4. And it started to take off. We sold a couple thousand that way on the internet, which was new at that time, and also at punk rock shows and craft fairs and stuff. And then it started to take off. So a light bulb went off, and I thought, oh, maybe we should get a book deal. So, yeah, I wrote a cheeky book proposal and sent them out, and 3 days later we had a book deal. And
now you're on the front of a calendar, but this is the book, so this is what it looks like
now,
huh?
This is How It All Began. This is the 10th anniversary edition, and there's been a few changes to it. You know, everybody needs a little nip and tuck every 10 years or so. So this is the first book, and then the second one was The Garden of Vegan. Then La Dolce Vegan, and this is my last one, Vegan A Go-Go.
Awesome.
And this one is the best, has recipes from the, from all three books, plus a bunch of new recipes, and you take this with you when you travel. So it fits in your back pocket, and if you go visit Grandma, you can make her a recipe. And
there you go.
Yeah.
Well, you brought in a lot of stuff, so why don't
I did.
I think this demonstrates just how far the movement's come. Go ahead.
Well, I mean, 10 years ago, the majority of these products, you really couldn't get them anywhere. Even vegan cookbooks, there were sort of few and far between, but these days, you know, you can get awesome vegan shoes from, you know, work appropriate to fancy pants.
If they're not made of leather, what are they made of?
They're made out of Vegetarian Shoes, which is a company out of the UK. They make their own sort of man-made leather,
and it's
fantastic.
Amazing.
This company, I can't say enough about it. It actually stretches, it breathes, you know, your feet don't smell. You can get lesser than man-made shoes at like stores like Payless and Eaton's and stuff, or Eaton's the Bay. Mm-hmm. But Vegetarian Shoes, and there's companies like Mink Shoes. They make really high quality vegan shoes, which are cruelty free and also really comfortable. So.
Right.
Yeah.
What else you got that you want to show us?
Well, being vegan is not just about food. It's also it's a lifestyle, and
it's about
so
shoes.
Well, it's always about shoes, my friend. But it's about everything. It's about from the makeup you wear to the milk that you drink, which is rice or hemp or oat or whatever. But you also want to make sure that your products aren't tested on animals. But also you want to make sure that they don't contain any animal ingredients. You can get a lot of this stuff at Whole Foods or your local health food store, but you can also order them online at places like veganessentials.com. There's a great place in Vancouver called Carmivore. There's a place down in the States called Cosmo's Vegan Shop. And so you can order sort of all this stuff. Vegan cheese.
Vegan cheese slices, for goodness sake.
Macaroni and cheese.
We're at time, yeah. So that recipe for butter tarts, we're going to put online.
Great, fantastic.
Right?
And, if you want any information about all of this stuff, I have it on my website, govegan.net.
There you go.
Yeah.
It's great to see you again.
Thanks.
10 years later.
Yeah.
For a great butter tart recipe and a link to Sarah's vegan website, you head to our website.
Loaded near the airport.